Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. Today we will talk about how to set up Go work environment on Windows and Linux. For macOS, please check the link in the description to my blog post. Then I will show you a couple of options for a text editor. I am personally using VS Code, so we will install VS Code and set it up for Go. In the end, we will write a small test program to see that everything works. So let's get started. So let's see how to install Go on Windows. Open your browser and navigate to go.dev. Then here, this is the official Go page. Now click on download button. Here we can see multiple OS versions. We need one for Windows. The latest version is 1.19 and we will download it. But if you want older version or some specific version of Go, you would find them below here. And also in this archived versions section. But now let's proceed. I will click here and download it. After download is finished, we need to run the program. We here need to click next. See that I accept is checked. Click next. By default, installer will install Go to program files. If you want, you can change the location. I will keep mine as a default and press next here. Just then press install. After installation is finished, click the finish button. Now open your favorite terminal. On Windows, I'm using PowerShell, or you can use command prompt. If you want a Unix-like terminal on Windows, you can install Git Bash. For that, you need to navigate to git-scm.com/downloads page here and download Git for Windows. But now I will open my PowerShell terminal here and type Go version and press enter. You should see message with installed version of Go. Just one notice here. If your terminal was open during the installation of Go, please restart your terminal to see the changes. Installing Go on Linux. Open your browser and navigate to go.dev. This is official Go page and click now on download button. Here, choose your system. For us, it's Linux. The latest version is 1.19 and we will download it and save it. After download is finished, we need to open a terminal. On Ubuntu, you can press Ctrl+Shift+T to open a terminal, and on PopOS, which I use right now, is Windows or Command key plus T. We need now to navigate to the downloads folder or wherever you saved file. If you already installed Go, we need first to remove older version of Go. For that, we need to execute next command as super user. If we installed it in user local Go, we need to remove it there. After we removed older version or we are installing for the first time, we need to extract archive that we just downloaded to user local folder. For that, we need to run this command also as a super user and press enter. Now we need to add user local go bin folder to our pet environmental variable. We execute this command export path equal pet and then user local go bin to append that to our pet variable. And then press enter. Changes that we made here won't apply until next time we log into our computer. to see changes immediately, we just need to run this command and then press enter. To see that we installed Go, we just need to type Go version and then press enter. Here you can see message with installed version of Go. Apart from Go that we previously installed, you need to have Git installed as well. If you already installed Git Bash, you have also Git installed. If not, you can download it from Git website or install it with your package manager. Next, we would need to install Integrated Development Environment or IDE or text editor of your choice. I will just mention a couple of options here. Here first we have Golang from JetBrains. It's paid software. If you like their products, you can go with that. For Vim users, there is Go extension that you can use. And the last one that I will use is Visual Studio Code. It's a free editor from Microsoft, and I think it's a very good option for Go. Let's open VS Code. What we need to do first is to install Go extension. Go to Extensions and search for Go. We need to select the first one, developed by Go team at Google, and click Install button. For Go extension to work properly, we need to install Go tools. To do that, we need to open Command Palette by going to View, then Command Palette, or just pressing Ctrl-Shift-P on Windows and Linux, or Command-Shift-P on macOS. And then we need to type Go install and then select Go install update tools. Here we check the box, select all the tools and click OK. After all the tools are installed successfully, we can test that everything is working by creating one small program and run it. Let's create file. It doesn't matter for now to understand the code. This program will print famous hello world to the terminal. Let's run the application. Here we can see the output, hello world. So, and that's it. You just set your Go environment. For relevant links, please check description below. Thank you for watching. If you liked the video, please press the like button. And if you would like to see more content like this, please subscribe to our channel. And for the text version of this material, please check link to my blog post in description below. Until the next time, bye.